Hello everybody. Today we are going to start a new topic, new concept, that is volume of cylinder. Okay. So what is mean by volume? Volume means space occupied by a solid is known as volume. So like that, space occupied by a cylinder is known as this volume. Okay. But how practically that we are going to see now. Okay. So see here, I have a ring, circular ring. Okay. If you see here, circular ring, the area of this ring will be pi r square. Everybody knows area of circle is pi r square because thickness is negligible here. Thickness is negligible. Okay, so we don't consider here thickness. So area directly we can write pi r square. Okay, so area of circle is equal to pi r square. Okay, when it is only circle, that time we take directly pi r square. Okay, but now how to calculate this volume? That we are going to see. Okay, see, area of this ring is pi r square. Okay, but suppose I will take such type of some rings together. Okay, top on top. Such type of rings I will take, then one cylinder will form. Okay, one cylinder will form. Now there is a thickness, or we can say height of the cylinder. Height of the cylinder takes place here. Okay, so this is the height of the cylinder, and area of this is pi r square. Okay, area of this is pi r square, and now height is formed, so we need to think about height also. Okay, so area of one is pi r square, and this height is h. Suppose we will take height of this is h. So what is the volume of this pi r square multiplied by h? Pi r square multiplied by h. So volume of cylinder is equals to pi r square h. Okay, so we are going to use that formula, pi r square h. Got it everybody? Area of this one ring is pi r square. And if I will take such type of some rings, okay, then I will get height will take place for this, and this one cylinder is formed. Okay, so that time we need to think about height of the cylinder. So if I want to find out volume of this, then I need to use pi r square multiplied by height of the cylinder. So pi r square h is the volume of cylinder, so that we are going to use. Okay, I told you the area of base ring is pi r square. Okay, so you can see here cylinder. Okay, this is circular, base is circular, so that area is pi r square. And this is the height of the cylinder. So if I want to calculate volume of the cylinder, so what I will do, volume of cylinder is equals to base area multiplied by height of the cylinder. Okay, so base area we use, it is circular, so it is pi r square multiplied by height of the cylinder, that we have denoted by h. So pi r square h. So pi r square h is the formula for volume of the cylinder. Okay, now one more thing we need to see, that is hollow cylinder. Okay, hollow cylinder, a volume of hollow cylinder. Okay, in that case again here this figure only you will see, in this figure, that is one more cylinder, inner cylinder. Okay, so there are two types of radius. One is external radius, from this point to this external radius, and from this to this is internal radius. So external radius we denote by capital R. Okay, volume of hollow cylinder. So external radius is equal to capital R, and inner radius will be denoted by small R. So this is capital R and this is small R. Okay, so volume of hollow cylinder is equals to external volume minus internal cylinder volume. Okay, so external volume, same formula we are going to use. What is that? pi r square h, because r, capital R, is the outer radius. So pi r square h minus internal cylinder volume is pi small r square h. okay, pi r capital R square h minus pi small r square h. Okay, so from this we can take common pi and h, this common we can take, so in bracket of this will be r square minus r square. Okay, pi into h into r square minus r square. So this way we have, with the help of this formula, we have to calculate volume of hollow cylinder. Okay, so two things we have seen. This is originally cylinder, right circular cylinder, that volume we will find out with the help of this pi r square h. And about hollow cylinder, there are two regions. Okay, so external volume is this external cylinder volume minus internal cylinder volume. So external volume radius is r, capital R, r. So here we have written pi r square h and its radius is small r, so pi r square h. So from this we have taken pi and h common because that is constant for both the cylinders. So in bracket what is going to remain? R square minus r square. So these two formulas we are going to use now to solve problem, this one and this one. Okay. So one problem we are going to see depend on this, very basic problem. So that I am reading now here. So that is the circumference of the base of a cylindrical vessel is 132 cm. Okay, circumference of a cylindrical vessel, such type of one vessel is there and its base circumference is given. Circumference of the base is given. Okay, circumference of this and circumference of top will be same because this is right circular. Okay, circumference of the base of a cylindrical vessel is 132 cm. So that I am taking here. Circumference is equal to 132 cm. Okay. Now, and its height is 25 cm. Height is given h. H is equal to 25 cm. Okay. How many liters of water it holds? In bracket it is given 1000 cm cube is equal to 1 liter. That everybody knows. Okay. So we will think afterwards. First we have to find out, circumference is given and height is given. Okay, to find out volume, which formula we use for volume, which formula we use? Pi r square h. Okay, pi, value of pi we know, that is 22/7. H is given, r is not given. So first we need to find out r, the radius of the cylinder. So for that we will use this circumference of the circle. Circumference, which formula we use? 2 pi r is equal to 132 cm. Okay, circumference will be divided by 2 pi. So 2 multiplied by 22/7 into radius is equal to 132 cm. So 22 are 44, 44 by 7 into r is equal to 132. So radius is equal to what? 132 multiplied by 7 and divided by 44 cm. Okay, so 44 3s are 132 and 7 3s are 21. So r is equal to 21 cm. Okay. So first we have to find out radius, because without radius we cannot find out volume. We have to find out volume here. Why we have to find out volume? Because they are asking here how many liters of water it holds in this vessel. How many liters of water it holds? Means we have to find out capacity of that cylinder. Okay. So here we have to find out volume of the cylinder. Okay, and volume of the cylinder we use formula pi r square h. So here r is unknown, radius is not given. So first we have to find out radius of the cylinder. Now easily we can find out volume of the cylinder. So volume of vessel, cylindrical vessel, is equal to pi r square h. Okay, so that is 22/7 multiplied by radius is, radius is 21 cm, 21 multiplied by 21 into height is given 25 cm. So 7 threes are 21. Okay, so this product will be 34,650 cm³. Okay, this product is 34,650 cm³. Okay, because volume is there, volume always comes in units cube, whatever unit is there, because 3 times centimeter into centimeter into centimeter will come. So volume will come in centimeter cube. Areas are coming in the square. Okay, centimeter square or unit square. Here it is, it will come centimeter cube. So this is the volume of this vessel. Now we have to convert this into liter, because here they have told us in liter. We have to find out answer in liter. So 1000 centimeter cube is equal to 1 liter. So here we need to divide by 1000. Okay, so we will divide here 34,650 divided by 1000 liters. So it will come after 3 decimal point 34.65 liters. So finally we got the answer in liters. Okay, so once again see here they will be why we are finding here volume, because they have told us how many liters of water it holds. So we have to find out capacity. Okay, three things are there: per surface area, total surface area, and capacity. Okay, so we must understand this. What actually we have to find out? First we have to decide it, and then we have to plan our answer. So circumference was given. With the help of circumference, we have to find out radius. Okay, and with the help of radius, we have to find out volume of this, and then we have to convert into liters. Okay, thank you.